jelek mukanya jadi ditutup.
Gua muka dan badan jelek ya kayak
apa? Semua dibolongin gini. Dari hole.
Hi, I'm Lunar.
Hi, what's good, Josh? Your girl in the G.
In the house. Hi, Lunar.
Hi, guys. I'm Katie.
She's back. She's
I'm back.
Katie from the block.
She's not back because she never left.
Katie
return.
Yes.
Okay. Kita hari ini Cep bakal ask questions to these ladies.
Justin's
the question that we're afraid to ask. Okay, can men split bills on first date?
They can. Maksudnya kalau gue sebagai cewek, I always offer. And if they say yes, then I'll pay. But if they say no, maksudnya kayak I'll be fine with them paying the bill. Tapi it also depends. Kayak who am I going on a date with? Either way, I'll offer. Tapi kayak kalau dia tajir banget, dia bilang no, I'll pay. I'm okay. Kalau dia kayak uni student doesn't have a job, you know, needs money, uh-huh. I'll still push to pay.
Right. Okay.
You know.
Fair enough.
For chicks. Wow, I got it. Maybe chicks.
Chicks over dicks. Chicks over dicks.
Yellow chicks.
All the comments are like, I want to be all the comments are luckiest chick in the world.
I'm actually the opposite. I always push to split the bill. And the only reason why I do that is because I don't want for me to feel like I either owe him something or that he feels like I'm entitled to give him something because he paid for my food. Vice versa, I don't want to pay for his bills and then him leaving the date feeling like, oh, he owes me something.
But what if he asked you on the date?
Either way, it doesn't really matter who asked who first, because either way, like, at the end of the day, both of us are interested, right?
That's a damn good answer. I guess you gotta wait.
Cool cast for the cool answer.
Wow!
Okay, so I have actually, like, paid prematurely on a date. Let's say the date isn't finished yet. Uh-huh. I'll just ask the waiter, hey, well, the bill yet? And then I'll pay for it. And then after he's like, oh, let's get the bill. I'm like, don't worry about it. I took care of it. Mm-hmm. So sometimes I'll do that. Mm-hmm. Or sometimes I'll ask, like, if he's like, buru buru, like, pay the bill. I'm like, oh, can we split it? Mm-hmm. Or I'll be like, I'll catch the next one.
Right.
Yeah, catching the next one.
For
good.
Me, like, I'll offer and I actually do mean it. Mm-hmm. If, let's say, I didn't enjoy the date and, like, I need to go, like, I'll actually pay. I'll
In
ask
advance.
The waiter. Like, I'll, like, go to the bathroom and be like, must only buy a scatter
and
jenga.
And you pay all of it.
I pay all of it.
It's gonna be a long night.
That's not like a power move. It's just like, I need to go. Uh-huh. That's my polite way of, like, trying to control.
So if you pay for all of it, it's a bad sign. The date's not going well.
Actually, yeah. I want to make sure that we part ways, and you're never gonna be like, oh yeah, I paid for Lunar's dinner, and she's
only. Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
The present untuk melawan buaya-buaya di sana. Okay. The next question: what's the differences between girls who are not interested or girls who are playing hard to get?
I think how hard to get, like, they'll still tease you. You have to expect them to at least reciprocate at one point. Mm-hmm. There needs to be a response from them. But if they're not interested in you, you're gonna hear nothing.
Here we go. I was shocked.
Ooh.
Damn.
If a girl has in mind that she might be interested, she's not gonna be so quick to say no, like, you know, leaving them on red. Like, that's a pretty sort of indirect, direct.
That's a no.
But if, you know, the woman is trying, you know, playing hard to get, there's gonna be a back and forth. Exactly what you said. And then when a woman is dead ass not interested, like, she will dead ass telling you no. Like, when a woman says no, it means no.
No is no.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh. The tea!
The tea!
Okay.
For me personally, a girl that plays hard to get will never say no. Like, she will never say the words no. That's very, like, straightforward. If she's playing hard to get, she'll giggle. She'll, like, her face will say yes, but her mouth will not say no either. It'll be like, maybe, like, but I feel like if you're not sure, better not to try, because that's just gonna be dangerous. Because if you push too hard and you think she's, like, playing hard to get, but how she's, like, dead ass, like, no. Mm-hmm.
That could get into some serious trouble.
Yeah, you could get into serious trouble.
Nice color with the golden chick.
Kisses.
Thank you.
And your top. It matches your top too.
All right. Why do girls always give mixed signals?
Because, kaya, that's how society has portrayed us in the past. Mm-hmm. We can't be, like,
too
assertive angry. And be like, I want this. Or because then they'll call us a bitch. Or they'll
if
say,
a man does it,
it's fine, he's a boss. Mm-hmm. But if a girl's like, I want this, and if you don't want this, then leave. Mm-hmm. Then people are like, iha pasti ko aggressive banget. Yeah.
Women have always been taught to be docile, to be reserved. And so part of that too is not only being able to directly and assertively say no, but also directly and assertively say yes.
I give you a baby because you are my baby. I give you the golden glitch.
Ooh. So swag.
Dang, I'm jealous. Look at her.
Another thing is like a lot of girls have trust issues as well from their past experience. Mm-hmm. So if she's sending mixed signals, I guess just be patient, be very like open to listening to her. She says no, again she says no, and like girls, like don't be afraid to like make a decision flat out. Like if you want to say something, just fucking say it. If they want to run away because you're being too casar or too rough, then they're not for you.
Yeah, that's why I will give you a dispenser.
Why?
She's thirsty.
Yeah.
Everyone's thirsty for their answer.
By the way,
what is it so hard for a girl to choose a place to eat?
Oh, yeah. I don't have that problem.
We love
unless
an assertive
like
queen.
Unless I'm sick or I'm on like my period, for example, then I get a bit kind of like, I don't know what I want.
Yes. I'm going to talk about that. So I have a point related to the period thing. So girls, their hormones are constantly fluctuating. And because of that, they become super indecisive. They don't know what they want because sometimes they want this, and then when their hormones change, they completely want something else. Just like when a girl's pregnant as well. When it comes to like periods, stuff like that, you just have to understand because it does have to do with like a biological thing when it comes to hormones.
Yeah. She's a doctor.
Okay.
That was outside the box.
Focus.
Anyways, actually I'm one of those people, I eat to live, I don't really live to eat. And so most of the time, I don't care where I eat as long as I just get something in me and I'll just go with whatever they want.
Oh, 20.
Hi. It's like you don't even have to say it.
Mama dad.
Okay, we'll save the gifts towards the end. Next.
Okay, next. What's your opinion about guys who want to get with you who are broke?
No. Well, get with me in what way?
Like dating.
Dating?
Sex.
Like dating. Serious dating? Because I'll fuck a broke guy. I don't fuck
first
care.
Date.
Kayak, for me personally, if he's broke, ya nggak apa-apa, yang penting dia tuh kayak responsible with his money. Kalau dia broke karena dia nggak bisa organize his money and he's taking you out on dates that he can't afford and not paying rent or like paying his phone bill or something, like that's a different thing. I don't care if you're broke as long as you're responsible with your money and you don't like you don't act like you're like so ya kayak so kayak I have money padahal nggak kayak ya nggak apa-apa just be straight up. You don't have to take me to a fancy restaurant if you can't afford it. We can eat sate padang on the side of the road. I don't care.
Can I just put some reality in here?
You go next. Go.
No one wants to date someone that's broke. Let's just be honest here. Because it's easier, right? If they're like well off or if they're like financially stable. So obviously the real answer is no. Ideally, we would all like to be financially stable. But financial literacy comes on top. Again, what Katie said. Like if you are not getting your finances in check, you don't know how to prioritize. Mm-hmm. That's a bigger thing for me. You can be as rich as fuck, but like you don't know how to manage your money. Mm-hmm. That's also a bad sign. Mm-hmm. So for me, it's not about how broke or how rich you are. It's just how you manage what you've got.
I think my only caution and worry, and I know that my mother feels the same way too, is that the potential of the man using me for my money. That's the thing that my mom always remind me about. And you know, it can come off a little bit elitist whenever my mom is, you know, telling me to find a man that is rich.
Yeah.
And her concern is always that the man can use me for my money.
How should a girl respond to the question, do I look ugly?
Tadi Cep, kayak kalau lo mau invest gitu kan, susah nggak sih kalau misalnya gaji aja udah pas-pasan?
Kalau ngomongin gaji sih, iya gue setuju sih kalau gaji pas-pasan ya. Tambah kan kalau nambahin besaran gaji kan juga.
Oh.
Nggak mungkin dapet, lah ya.
Kita dapat UMR aja udah syukur.
Dapat kerja aja syukur kondisi sekarang. Nah cuma kalau gue sih mikir expense yang diubah. Let's say.
Ya iya sih.
Kalau orang tuh ngomong investasi, mereka mikirannya tuh duitnya yang harus puluhan juta, ratusan juta, duit-duit gede.
Iya, yang kayak di film-film gitu pakai koper.
Fancy, kan? Yang kayak dateng, mau investasi, seret.
Iya, iya,
cuma, inilah kenapa makanya gue personal reason gue untuk pilih pakai menggunakan Bibit. Satu, kalau praktis udah pasti.
Oke.
lu gak bakal pusing, dia udah robo advisor.
Iya sih, kayak enak di app langsung. Gitu langsung tek-tek.
Dan you say, iya, dia friendly banget buat user-user kayak kita yang gak terlalu paham tentang finansial. Dan yang kedua, dia bisa start dari 10 ribu.
Hah?
10 ribu.
Itu mie ayam.
Nah, ibarat kalau lu ngomong, iya gaji gua pas-pasan. Sekarang pertanyaan gua gini deh, lu ngopi berapa deh sehari?
Oke, dua kali.
Minimal dua lah ya. Minimal ya.
Karena sometimes tiga.
Pagi, siang, atau enggak pagi, sore. Itu udah minimal tuh ya.
Iya sih.
Ya kalau misalkan lu pasti ada jajan-jajannya, kopi ketiga, atau enggak kayak, ya lagi ada promo nih.
Iya, kalau ada cashback, kan. Tambah. Dapat nah, poin, aduh.
Ibarat kalau misalkan lu sisihin itu deh. Ibarat yaudah deh, dua kopi lu tuh wajib. Nah kopi ketiga dan jajan-jajannya ini lu sisihin deh. Bisa dong.
Iya sih, sekecil itu pasti bisa.
Dan ini kan apalagi buat masa depan lu. Iya. Di situ. Makanya kayak dengan cuma 10 ribu itu.
Jadi kayak, ya kalau kayak gitu sih semua orang juga bisa ya. Bukan kayak itu sesuatu yang hanya untuk orang yang udah jadi manajer gitu, banyak duit baru invest.
Nah, setuju. Semua orang bisa. Tapi udah pada mau belum? Sama udah kepikiran.
No, baby, you look like the prettiest girl in the world, baby girl. Just hype her up. It's all about confidence when it comes with girls. So as long as you make her feel like the most confident person in the room, then, you know, she will look amazing no matter what. You just have to hype her up. Unless like she has like something in her teeth, then you better tell her.
Oh, yes. Know? Or like if her, you know, eyeliner, mascara smudging.
Yeah.
Let the bitch know.
Just say yes and like be patient. And then just make it cute. You know what I mean, guys? If you start being defensive as well, then that's when shit starts to, you know, even if she doesn't believe you, guy. Oh, of course, babe. No, you're beautiful.
Or
just make it super cute. Trust me. Like,
Or every time she walks into a room, before she even asks you, just be like, dang, girl. Like,
damn, bitch, you got cake.
So good.
your girlfriend walks into a room. Dang.
Dang, girl.
What's the finding? What do you think about slutty men?
Personally, to me, a slut is gender neutral. So whatever you think a female slut is, in a place that it goes both ways, onto the man's side.
So
a slutty man is a fuck boy. And what I think a slutty man, I think it would depend on where I'm at in life at the moment. And where I'm at in life at the moment is that
love him.
Love him.
The sluttier the better.
Mom, don't watch this, but yeah.
A slutty man, slide into her DMs.
Call me. No, I was kidding. But I will say though, if I'm at a place in my life where I'm looking for something serious, I mean, like, no, but everybody's at different, you know, phases in their lives.
In their life.
Yeah, and like, see, I am a big advocate for being a hoe. Go out there, be a hoe, experiment, do whatever the fuck that you want. Just.
As long as you're single, not hurting anyone.
Exactly, as long as you're
doing
single.
It safely, using protection.
Period. Like, do whatever the fuck you want as long as it's not hurting nobody. Like, as long as you still remember your responsibilities and, you know, all that good shit.
As much as I think slut-shaming women is wrong, I also don't really believe in slut-shaming men. Again, I'll probably hear from other people, like, if I'm seeing someone, they're like, oh, this guy fucks around a lot. I'll probably distance myself. I'm not assuming anything, but it's like, okay, like, I've heard the stories. I'm not gonna judge you in any way, but like I'll keep my my distance. I'll just be cautious about it. So I don't really have an opinion on them, but like not my type. Okay?
But you still be friend.
Yeah. Be friends with them. Okay. Yeah.
That's fair.
If the man is a little bit too slutty, if he a little bit, you know, too easy, and you know he literally fucks everything that breathes and moves.
If there is a hole, there is a way.
I'm coming at it from a place of caution because it's a higher likelihood that he's gonna have some sort of STD.
Yeah, that's what.
That's true. Yeah.
I mean, I love my slutty men, but maybe not a little, not too slutty. Can I say
within
that?
Within reason.
Within reason, yes. Within reason. Be a slut within reason.
Mm-hmm. I personally, like, I'm not too big a fan of slutty men. Like, I'll be friends with them. If I really, really like you and you had a past, it's fine. Same like Lunar. Okay. But I'd like to feel like you're with me for a reason. I don't like to feel like you're with me just because you fuck everything that moves. Or just because you have no standards. Like,
of course.
And I'm not saying a guy that sleeps around doesn't have standards, but I just want to feel special. Like, mm-hmm. I want to feel like... Value. You're I feel like if you sleep with everyone, it makes me less valuable in your eyes.
Uh-huh. Oh, big point. There's actually an issue. Guys that sleep around a lot, they get desensitized with sex. So when they have sex in relationships, it's not like a big thing for them. For me, like, I can't do that. Okay. Once guys sleep around for like a very long time, they don't really see the value behind like actual intimacy.
Oh, value.
So when they do it with you, like, I'll feel this disconnect. So I find that guys that actually have lower body counts, I can connect with them more. Not that I'm judging anyone, but I've never done the casual sex thing. Like, again, what you said, I don't know how to manage the whole STD thing. Yeah, personally, like, I would like to find someone that values the intimacy and, like, sex the way that I do. Mm.
But I think Cheppy is really sensitive towards sex. Girl?
I'm sensitive towards the relationship.
Yeah.
Okay, do you girls have locker room talk?
Girls definitely have locker room talk, and I think it's become more common now since, like, girls are more open about being sexual beings and being more open with their friends about their sexuality, because it's not like we don't shame our friends for, you know, having sex or whatever. Mm-hmm. But yeah, definitely, and I think it brings power to, like, us women by, like, if guys can do it to us, like, we probably might talk about you as well.
Mm-hmm.
Will, but most, like, not to everyone, obviously.
But it's crazy when guys act shocked. I can't believe they said this about me. It's like, bitch, you probably said
you've done the same thing.
Girl,
you do the exact same
thing. The difference is, if you're obviously hurting people and spreading rumors, that's one thing. But, like, I think the worst thing I've ever heard is, like, sorry, okay. I'd fuck him, but with a paper bag over his head. Like, that's really
bro,
tough.
That's mean.
That's mean.
Give her a gift. Jadi dia.
Jelek mukanya jadi ditutup.
Gua muka dan badannya jelek ya kayak apa?
Semua. Ini bolong gini. Ini dari
Hollywood. Ah. Papan ini. Well, this comes to one of the most important questions for guys. Don't worry, boys, I got you. Does size matter?
It does.
Coming from a tiny girl.
You know what? There is such a thing as too big. If you guys, shameless plug, I guess, but if y'all want to hear the story, go over to my YouTube channel.
Her Nigerian gangbang.
About the Nigerians. What? But there is so much conversation about how, oh, like, you know, the dick needs to be, like, big, or, like, you know, how big is the dick? But, like, y'all need to take into consideration that a small girl has a small pussy, right? And if it's too big, it fucking hurts. Okay, I'm a tiny ass fucking bitch. Like, even standing compared to, like, these two, right? So imagine if I'm fucking a guy that's 6 feet tall.
I'm fun size.
I'm not a mink.
Pocket size.
I'm not a
pocket size.
Pocket size. I'm a little Pokemon. Keeps sizes relative.
So does it matter? So it does matter, yeah?
It 100% matters. The girth and the length.
Girth over length.
Yes.
Over length.
I will
what
say that.
Girth?
Yes.
Girth or lebar?
So gini ya? So gini.
Ini
ya jadi.
Bapak lu segini tapi lebar segini.
See, because the thing is, it's technically the length that hurts.
Because
you know,
it hits
the cervix.
Hurts good.
It's about not only that, the size, but the motion of the ocean.
Yes.
The way you're, like, going at it, that's key.
I heard this before.
So
is
like,
it true?
Yes. Yeah, no, it's
the motion of the ocean.
100.
So, like, there's really big, but if he doesn't know how to use it,
it's gonna
women
like
will
shit.
Prefer a more average size, but he... The chemistry is there and you guys connect in a rhythmic way.
And he knows how to move his body.
But there is also a thing as too small. Too small is like when, too small is when you're like, babe, put it in. And he's like, what do you mean?
It's
that's
little,
too small.
It's a little choke.
It's a choke. Yeah, I have small dicks. Did it discourage you?
Oh, no, but like we said, motion of the ocean. And also chemistry.
Passion and chemistry is...
That's what matters.
I will say,
sex when you are in love with a man, or like, you know, you feel some type of way with a man, oh, it's so much better than like,
right.
You know, a friend with benefit that you don't got no feelings for, or like a one night stand, you know?
Why do girls fake orgasm?
Because y'all suck. No, I'm just kidding.
We cannot beat the machine.
What machine are we talking about?
A machine.